All right, so now I guess I'll discuss dealing with the elderly persons, people. Since moving here to this part of the United States, there seems to be, I've had a lot of action or reaction with elderly people here. I think there's a lot of people who move here just because they're older. And then I'm like, well, it hasn't been always great, okay? I'm not always getting along with them. They are, what is the thing I will say? It's almost like as each year goes, they become a little bit more miffy. Can I use that terminology? Meaning, miffy, meaning things get like, no, it has to be just right. Things have to be just right. Things have to be just so. And especially if it's that type of personality anyway, that was that way in their former life, when they were not, you know, in the, running around with some kind of brain slow or stroke or whatever. Yeah, they're just like real, I won't say argumentative necessarily, I won't say argumentative, but they are not accepting anything. I mean, this is the problem, isn't it? It's just mum is the word. That's really what it comes down to. They don't like to be controlled. They don't like that because that goes into the independence factor, doesn't it? Like their independence is at a halt already, feels at a halt. They're frustrated, they can't do things like they used to. So their independence factor, just, you know, if you're the person who supplies them food or whatever, you are the enemy in a way, because you're canceling their independence factor. See, they used to be able, or they used to do those things, and then that person is doing those things, you start to be the enemy, because the independence factor is like, I'm no longer that anymore. So the frustration, don't call me old, you know, the frustration build, you know, I can drive, I can, you know, I can do this, I can do that, when in reality that there's the can't, you know, you can't. But there's the non-acceptance, because there's a huge non-acceptance with each year passing that their independence is gone. They're like, no, I can still do those things, I can still, I'm a capable human being. And I'm like, no. And they don't want to hear no. They don't want to hear no. They don't want to hear you're confused. They don't want to hear any of that. Never. They just want it easy. They just want to receive. They want to live on a pillow, you know, a satin pillow, and receive whatever they want. Whatever they require, whatever they say, whatever they decide. They're very, very much so this way. And it's difficult because I've encountered one, two, three, definitely three, heavy, four, maybe five. Seems like each old elderly person I meet is the same. I'm like, and how did this happen? And I can blame this, I can go back and blame this on the customer service industry. I can go back and blame it on commercialism, the customer's always right, you know. Because in a way, it is embedded into their head, the customer's always right, that they can get what they want. You know, they can put their $5 there and they get what they want, you know. And they can be mean when they say it. Doesn't matter. They don't have to be nice or kind because they're older, you know. So it's just like, what's going on? You know, so they get this extra atrocious self. We call it the grumpy old man syndrome, I guess. You can call it that a lot. It's been called grumpy old man, but for years and years. But the solve to it is, I guess, a lot of the time, mum is the word. But then sometimes, oh my gosh, today I snapped at my dad in the store, and I didn't, you know, like, yell at him like loud so a lot of people heard or anything, but I mean I told him, I said, we're going shopping and you don't have to go, but he wanted to, and I'm like, well, it's just for a few things and I know you're not gonna like it, you know. So I did have that, I prepared him for the event, but still it didn't go well, you know. Because his independence factor is traipsed on anymore, you know? And so I am the enemy. Anybody who is helping him as his, you know, daily helper does become an enemy in a way, because his independence factor is gone. Or I can't just say my father. I have to say all the fathers. All the fathers, you know. Sad to say, it's not anything to him. It's all the dads. And so when we look at ourselves as agers, like, are you aging? Maybe this is something to avoid. Maybe this is something to go, well, that generation, the customer service generation, I think we're the next one, what are we, Generation X? We're like the return generation. We're the generation of returns. We take things to the store or we return it back. We buy it and it didn't work. Maybe we're the return generation. We don't really want the customer service so much, but we just want the product to work, or we return it. And we want that returned quickly and easily. But when you look at the generations themselves, you know, the one that is like in their 70s or so, that one was really the shopper generation. They were the shopper generation. And that's who you have as a president also, Trump. He's a shopper generation. They were major buyers into this customer service thing. They're the ones who went to all of the House of the Pancakes, and they had their meals, and everything was just like that steady ritual. Of even like after church on Sunday, you go out to one of those Denny's or something. And so all of these things, they were very ritualistic in their lives. And we sure are changing away from that. All those big chains, I think they're going to be held out for who in the future. I don't think it's going to be the computer people. I just don't think so. I think the computer people are going to be not major players in those village of pancakes and the Denny's and Wenny's. I think we're just not of that same ilk, you know what I mean? We're not the same. We can't, in a way, you know. It's much of the energy is around this computer self moment. So we can't really spend it out there. But that generation sure did drag us out there, didn't it? It dragged us out there when we were younger, we were kids, and like, you know, I had a great aunt. She was my aunt. Yeah, my aunt. And, you know, she was the one who had like five husbands. She was something else. She always had to go out and eat. You know, so she was the type of person like that, and so I'm like, well, yeah, she's gone though, and she's gone now. So that's 80s. Yeah, she left in her 86th year, and I think we're losing a lot of that group. That's all. And we have a lot of grumpies still. But the thing is. The terrible thing is, with any of this, like we call it dementias or Alzheimer's or memory loss and The problem that we're having is if you don't treat the elderly with the kid gloves, I don't know, like really calm and really passive and don't bark ever, if you do not treat them kind and with kid gloves, oh my gosh, they can get their feelings hurt. And I mean feelings hurt. And it's a shock. It's a shock to you at first, because oh my gosh, when they were younger, I mean, they were dastardly human beings. And now you can just, if you spur a little fire at their direction, oh my gosh, they're not crying, but they can get their feelings hurt. So yeah, like today at the store, I'm just shopping. I'm buying what I'm buying. You know, I have to do all this for the house, and he just doesn't understand. He wants to go through his old life and look, price is too heavy, or that price is too high, all of these things. He wants to do that. But in reality, there's no time for that. There's no time for going and looking at every little thing like that when you're older. Because the mind doesn't gather the items anymore. The mind doesn't know how to shop any longer. So when the mind doesn't know how to shop any longer, but it still remembers a few things. It still remembers, in a way, it remembers that sentence in the head of the price being too high. You know, even though the price really wasn't that high. So in reality, I don't know. It's tough, because it's when they get their feelings hurt. And, I am just sorry. You can be sorry if you bark too loud. But I don't know how these people who work in these rest homes survive. Are they on drugs? I mean, how do they deal with the elderly? Like that many? How do they? I just don't know. Because I have, so far, my bark limit, and I know it, and I go to it sometimes, and I'm like, God dang you, what'd you do that for? What did I bark that way for? Ever? How do they do that? How do they turn off any like normal reaction? How do those people who work in there in those facilities turn it off? At one point I'm sitting here thinking, well, maybe they drug the water or something, and then all of the people there, the rest home patients, are just like, they're not going to bark. They're not going to be grumpy. They're not going to fight. They're not going to be argumentative or wantful. But it's not true. I mean, the place that my dad's sister is in, those people are in agony sometimes. They're yelling, "Let me out! Let me out of here!" You know, there's a woman who yells this, and it's like a prison. They don't actually let them go outside by themselves, and so it becomes like a sanitarium, a real sanitarium situation, where the door just doesn't let them out, because they have to go with certain people if that's going to ever happen, and those people just don't show up. They get left in these places. It doesn't matter if they're spending $5,000 or $7,000 a month, they're left there. And they just yell in agony, in the middle of the rest home place, yelling, "Let me out of here." They're suffering, like seriously suffering. And it's like, how was that a choice? How was that a choice to put that woman in there? How was that a choice ever? How was that? And yet that's it. That's the answer for all of these parents. That's the system. It just is like a torture box that they're going into. But the problem is, how can one person, like me, let's say, how can one person deal with it? How can one human being deal with it? Because they become so unhandleable. You know what I mean? Unhandleable. So, I mean, luckily my dad is easygoing at the moment. At the moment he's in a good mood. He's not fighting tiger or anything. He's in a good mood. And he's all right with being an old person, and he's all right with me, you know, finding his TV channels and all of this stuff. He's all right. But 6 months ago, oh my gosh, he was madder than hell at me. Madder than goddamn hell that he couldn't change the channel. It's just taking him a long time to accept that you know, it's the acceptance ladder. They just don't want to accept their age. They don't want to accept their independence is gone. They don't want to accept it. They're just madder than hell. They're going out of this world going, how did this happen? How did this happen? And then this is the type of person we have as the President of the United States. He's the same age group, folks. He's exact same age group. And so you have to look at all of the geriatrics, you have to look at all of the elderly, you have to look at all of their, we're talking about their mood swings. And this guy has got the trigger on countries across the world. I mean, we should outlaw having old presidents. This should not be allowed. We should never have anybody over a certain age able to become a president, able to become anything in charge of a country. Luckily, when I took over France, ha ha ha, it was back when I was in my 40s. Luckily, you know what I'm saying? My gosh! So we have to look at the difficulty here. The difficulty of dealing with, I mean, with their monstrosities of requests, their monstrosities of orders, and Trump is a perfect example of what he has done. It's almost like the list. He's like, oh, I'm king now. I get to do all this, you know. And he's had a list. He's just going and checking everything off on that list, everything, you know. Yeah, it's like given free rein. All of a sudden. So it's the same as, it's very same, similar as the Alzheimer's or the dementias that are like, I get what I want, or I can be very, very, very hurt. Very hurt physically. Physically? No, I didn't mean that. Mentally, emotionally. Anyway. So, like I said, so how do we do that? How do we stop the politicians being there? You know, I can understand somebody who got in there a long, long time ago, let them stay, but the person who has been, you know, just put in there when he's in his 70s is outrageous. Bad system. And unfortunately, that's where the money is. They made it such an insanity, you know, that you have to have hundreds of millions to become a president, that the money was only available by somebody who was over 70, you know. You could only really find people, that many people, that would be that wantful to be a president, and they're over 70, you know. So with that much money. So that's what we're dealing with. is a precedent that we have to kind of, you have to assuage. That's the word I've been trying to find. I'm sorry. You have to assuage the elderly. Is the elderly the wrong word? The older, the ancients, assuage them, and yeah, because they are very prideful human beings. They do not want to be have anybody take their independence away. So that's what we're dealing with. I don't know if that helps anything. Gosh dang it. Anyway, yeah, so if you're out there and you're taking care of one of these older people, or you know older people around you, don't try not to bark, because they will get offended. Don't bark at them ever. I don't know where I put my barks, you know, because that's my natural reaction. Where do you put your barks? That's the problem. Because they are almost like forcing you to change your personality. Like, well, where do I, you know, how do I redirect any, like, you know, where do you redirect it? You know, you're pushing me off a cliff. You know, where do I redirect it? You know. Anyway, I guess that's it. We're dealing with the redirections. Yeah, and assuaging, making them feel, like they're still independent, while they're not, and don't let them know it. I mean, it's tough. Anyway, it's very tough. I just can't believe it, actually. I had no idea the older people were like this. I had no idea. Maybe it's older men, because older women, the older women, like my grandmother. No, I don't know. Maybe they're all that way. Maybe they're all that way. Hard to please. And then when they are given and they have received, they are, you know, have their food, everything is fine, and then yes, everything is wonderful. Everything is wonderful all of a sudden. And that's a weird trick. It's like, what? But just 2 days ago, everything was awful. Now today, everything is wonderful. It's like a wheel. It's like the brain is on a wheel, and I'm like, I got that part of the wheel today, that everything is wonderful, and then I have to wait for it to all be awful again, because when that happens, that's a terrible day. Yeah. Anyway, I don't know. Like I said, there's nothing I can do except wait. Wait for what? Wait for what? I planted some flowers. No, some trees. See, I'm not ditzed out. I planted trees today. I planted a plum tree and an orange tree. You know, and that gives me something to do, obviously. I'm making this mega garden. I don't know. They're really tough. And then I need people here. I have a third bedroom in this house. I need another person here to help pay for the property tax. I need that room filled with a human being. I don't know how I'm going to do that. Cuz I can't handle another person older. I can't. You know, are they all this way? Are they all this way? I mean, is it all about the force the people who care for them to be just passivated to, like, practical drug addict passivation? Because it does feel like I have to be like a drug addict passivist. You know, force myself to be like a drone. So I don't have any kind of spring back or discussion or lively left. It does feel like it they are forcing the caregivers to be drones. I don't like it. I don't like it. Anyway, luckily my dad is a good dude. For the most part, he's a good dude. And he takes walks. You know, luckily he exercises still. So I am, what do we call it? In a way, this is like the good time. I don't want it to get worse. Don't you understand? I don't want it to get worse. I don't want him in a wheelchair. I don't want it to get worse. Jesus Christ. You know, I can't stand it. And I don't have, like, my brothers as helpers. They've decided to be antagonizers to me and say, go get a job. They want me to go get work. I'm sorry. Their heads are on backwards, that they don't recognize. They don't want to recognize, you know, what an elderly person is. They just don't want to recognize it. So, anyway, so I don't get any help from them. I mean, whether they want my dad to just keep walking off a cliff one day, you know, I don't get it. I understand, you know, give him his independence up to the last minute as much as possible, but you can't give elderly people independence as much as possible. There's a point where, no, they can't wash the dishes anymore because they just can't. And that job is taken away. It's taken away for a reason, you know. It's taken away for a lot of reasons, aside from, you know, making the dishes clean, and, you know, you have to save the water, you know. That's another thing I'm finding elderly people are not capable of doing. They're not good at saving. They're not good at saving water, they're not good at saving money, they're not good at saving. I don't understand where that went. Apparently that went out the window. Anything to do with saving. You know, I'm worried. I'm worried and I for my uncle. I'm worried for how he acts. I'm worried for my father. I'm worried for other people. You know, like maybe, you know, you water too much and these types of things. I all these silly, stupid things, you know, crop up into my head. And I'm like, what am I going to do? Because they're independent. I can't tell them no. You know, I can't get my father to take a shower that is only 15 minutes. You know, he will take a shower that is 30. And there's nothing I can do. Nothing. It's like that was their generation and they're allowed to just take 30-minute showers. And so thusly, I don't even bathe. I swear, I take a shower once a week. And I feel like the older generation is destituting my generation. You know, they're such takers. They're such takers, and they're incapable of acknowledging the take, that they're destituting their children. Do you understand? They're ecology destituting them. You know, I mean, I would like to take a shower more. But it's just the way it goes. I mean, it's just, what the heck? just the way it goes. You know, they have to be given all these things. All of these things have to be given, or they're retroactions back at us, and they're really mean. I mean, he can just say, "You're out. I kick you out," and he'll call the police, and I'll be out on the street. This is how horrible it is. You know, when you're dealing with the mind that just wants that customer service and has been taught it and taught it and instructed it and given it, you know, for just a small amount of money, they've just been taught it and they expect it. Anyway, luckily, what? I don't know. I just don't know what I'm walking into. I don't know what I'm walking into further from this situation. Because I don't have the money to... Nobody has this type of money to put... I mean, look at this. There was an Indian, a Native American Indian, apparently lived 137 years. Okay, so 137 years? What? I don't know if he was even a brain at that point. Or if he was just a pain the entire time for the last 50 of his life. He could have been a pain. Anyway, like I said, I need to fill that room, and my dad doesn't want anybody here. He doesn't want anybody here. He wants his room, in his room his way, and I'm in my room my way, and that room is empty. Darn it, because I needed the money. And I was okay for a house share. I would put a violinist in there. But it's tough when they're older people, isn't it? And now I need an old violinist. And so, well, if I can find an old violinist, somebody can listen to me singing. Or it could be an old trumpet player, a trombone player. I don't care. A cellist. But... yeah. What a weird life. I don't have the solution for the elderly. I just don't. And there are just certain diseases out there that are prevalent more and more. And it's this dementia, Alzheimer one. Scary. It's a scary one. And like my aunt's friend, my aunt's mother had it. No, well, she's my aunt-in-law. My aunt-in-law's mother had it. You know, it's just all over the place here. And we have to be so kind to them. I am not kidding. We have to be so kind. You know, I'm running out of my kind factor some minutes. Dang it. And then I just feel terrible. I feel like the worst person in the world. They make us feel like the worst person in the world if you run out of your kind factor. Oh my God. Anyway, there's nothing I can do except, I'm in the house and I need the money for a person to live here. I need to convert the garage into a fourth bedroom. I need to turn this into like one of those Ithaca share houses that had 20 people in a house, you know. That's the way Ithaca goes. You have the Ithaca share houses. You put 20 people in. I have up here above my bed, I have like an alcove there's a ladder. You can take a ladder up there and put a bed. So I can make a fifth bedroom, you know. I can make a little wall over there and make a sixth bedroom. I'm not kidding. It's expensive. Very expensive. anyway. Yeah, so I have my mind open for that. I'm aware. I could be a house crammer. House crammers, is that what you call it? House crammers. But unfortunately, right now it would be like what with the grumpy old men. I don't want house crammers with grumpy old men. I can't stand it. I can't stand it. It's like who's caring for Donald Trump right now? Because maybe that's part of the problem. Let's look at his caregiver. Which would be, I guess, all of the people that are in his, they call it like his office, his, who works with him. Those people have got to put on their nice, they have to debark, they have to bring down all of those levels. They have to put themselves on passivation drone and calm that boy down. Otherwise, you're just dealing with a guy that's like, yeah, pushing the button. Just a nut.